In this video, we're going to start the CUDA software Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet factoring special cases. We're factoring special case polynomials. If you remember, in a previous CUDA software worksheet, we multiplied special case polynomials. Now, we're going to be factoring, so doing the reverse, essentially. Remember, a squared minus b squared was the same as a plus b times a minus b, or vice versa, a minus b times a plus b. A squared plus 2ab plus b squared was equal to a plus b squared. And a squared minus 2ab plus b squared was equal to a minus b, and that squared. So remembering that, let's look at number 1. In number 1, we have a squared minus b squared. So we can factor that into a plus b times a minus b. So in this case, a squared is equal to 16 in squared, and b squared is equal to 9. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take the square root of both sides in my a squared equation, and I'll get that a is equal to the square root of 16 in squared, which is the square root of 16 times the square root of n squared, splitting up what's inside that square root, and that'll be a is equal to 4n. And b, when I take the square root of both sides of that, I'll get that b is equal to the square root of 9, which is 3. So I'll plug a and b in for a plus b times a minus b. So I'll have 4n plus 3 times 4n minus 3. And that is 16n squared minus 9 factored. In number 2, again, I have a squared minus b squared. So that's going to be a plus b times a minus b. My a squared, in this case, is 4m squared, and my b squared is 25. So if I was to take the square root of both sides in both my a squared equation and my b squared equation, I'll get a equal to 2m. Since the square root of 4 is 2 and the square root of m squared is m, and I'll get that b is equal to the square root of 25, which is 5. So plugging a and b into a plus b times a minus b, I'll get 2m plus 5 times 2m minus 5 as my solution in number 2. In number 3, I'll have a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. So that's going to be a minus b squared. My a squared term is 16b squared. My 2ab is equal to 40b, and my b squared is 25. Solving for a, I'll take the square root of my first equation to get that a is equal to 4b, since the square root of 16 is 4 and the square root of b squared is b. Now I can either plug a into the second equation, or I could solve for b in my third equation. I'll solve for b in the third. I'll take the square root of both the left and right side of my equation to get b equal to 20. The square root of 25 is 5. I want to double check to make sure 2ab is 40b. Then I know that I can write my factor as a minus b squared. So I'm going to plug in a and b in for 2ab. So I'll get 2 times a, which in this case is 4b, and I'm going to multiply that to b, which is 5. Not confusing the b of my equation with the b in my formula. And is that equal to 40b? If it is, I can write this factor as a minus b squared. 2 times 4 is 8, 8 times b is 8b, times 5 is indeed 40b. So since 40b is equal to 40b, I can plug a and b into my formula. So a is 4b minus b, which is 5, and I'm squaring that. So 4b minus 5 squared is my solution in number 3. If I was to multiply 4b minus 5 times 4b minus 5, I would get 16b squared minus 40b plus 25. Moving on to number 4, I have a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. So that will give me a minus b squared. My a squared term is 4x squared. My 2ab is equal to 4x. And my b squared term is 1. Solving for a, I'll take the square root of both sides to get that a is equal to 2x. Now solving for b, I'll take the square root of b squared and the square root of 1 to get that b is equal to 1. Now I'll plug each of those in for 2ab and see if that indeed equals 4x. So I have 2 times 2x times 1. Does that equal 4x? Yes, 4x equals 4x. So I know that 2x minus 1 squared will give me the polynomial 4x squared minus 4x plus 1. In number 5, I have a squared minus b squared. That factored is a plus b times a minus b. My a squared is 9x squared, and my b squared is 1. Taking the square root of my equation with my a, I'll get that a is equal to 3x. Taking the square root of b squared equals 1, I'll get that b is equal to 1. So plugging in my a and b, I'll get 3x plus 1 times 3x minus 1. That is my solution in number 5. In number 6, I'll use my same formula, a squared minus b squared. That's equal to a plus b times a minus b. A squared is n squared, and b squared is 25. Taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that a is equal to n. Taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that b is equal to 5. So n plus 5 times n minus 5, a plus b times a minus b, is my factored solution in number 6. In number 7, a squared minus b squared equals a plus b times a minus b. N to the 4th represents a squared, and 100 is b squared. So taking the square root of a squared and the square root of n to the 4th, I'll get that a is equal to n squared. Taking the square root of b squared and the square root of 100, I'll get that b is equal to 10. So for a plus b times a minus b, I'll have n squared plus 10 times n squared minus 10. And if you want to double check, feel free to use the FOIL method. First, outside, inside, last, multiplying each term of one polynomial to each term of the other polynomial, and you will get n to the 4th minus 100. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 8. In number 8, we have a to the 4th minus 9. That's going to be a squared minus b squared, which will equal a plus b times a minus b. A squared, in this case, is a to the 4th. B squared, in this case, is 9. Solving for the a in my formula, I'll take the square root of both sides to get that a is equal to a squared. So that means that I'm plugging a squared in for the a in this formula. That does not necessarily mean that a in here is also equal to a squared. This is the a within my formula. So if you want to use a subscript, such as a sub 1, to make sure that you keep your a value separate, feel free to do that. So a sub 1 equals a squared. And b squared, taking the square root of both sides, b equals 3. So I'm going to plug in my a sub 1 value, which is a squared, in for a sub 1, and I'm going to plug in 3 for b. So I'll get a squared plus 3 times a squared minus 3. And that is my final solution in number 8. So again, if you get confused using a in the formula and a within your polynomial, feel free to write in subscripts to keep them separate or change the variable. A squared minus b squared you could also write as x squared minus y squared, and write that as x plus y times x minus y. so feel free to do whatever method works best for you. And with that, I'll wrap up this video. Join me in the next video, where I'll do numbers 9 through 16. And if you haven't already, click that subscribe button and like this video.